Everyone, and welcome back to episode 46 of Katawa Shoujo. Let's
go.
I've done it again.
I'm still bothered. Yeah, I'm still from review by Yuko's triumphant shout. Yuko seems mortified by my sudden starting. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. And it's just that... As she stutters, I move quickly to calm her down before she gets too agitated. Whoa. Hey. My words seem ineffective. Yuko continues to work herself into a complete frenzy.
And it's a library and I shouldn't be.
Easy there. Just calm down.
And I'm really setting a bad example, and now I'll get fired because I can't do anything right.
Yuko!
Charm seems to work, but I draw the ire of several students studying in the library. Yuko snaps to attention, like a soldier who's just did the Captain Barker order.
Sorry.
Calm down, it's okay. It just startled me a little. But that's only because I was daydreaming instead of studying. So. Really? You got me back on task. This is a complete lie, but it seems to work. Yuko takes a deep breath. It seems to calm down a little. Though she keeps shifting around with a nervous energy that seems awfully familiar. So, what's got you excited anyway?
The Yamaku cat burglar.
To her credit. Yuko manages to convey her intense excitement into a whisper.
I think I know who it is. I got an anonymous tip as to their identity. So I did some spying, and I think the tipster was right.
Oh really? And who was this burglar? Yuko shuts her mouth, shaking her head decisively.
No, I can't tell you that.
Why not?
It's between me and the burglar. I can't risk you warning him that I'm onto his game. He could tip his hand early and blow it out. Then I'm left with no prep.
When did you first start talking like a hard-boiled detective? On them, why would I care?
If you've got to ask that question, then you don't need to know.
That doesn't make any sense. Okay. Congratulations, I guess.
Thanks. What for?
The cat burglar thing. Yuko nods and smiles appreciatively.
So, studying for exams?
Well, that was the plan. Not having much luck, though.
Really? Is it because you can't find the book? I'm really sorry. I've been meaning to clean the shelves up for weeks now, but I keep getting distracted. I'm so sorry.
Well, wait. It's not that. I've got my book right here. To illustrate the point and hopefully calm you down, I show her the textbook in front of me. My mind just keeps wandering as well.
Is it because of the noise in here?
I'm trying to be more strict about the noise levels, but I can't bring myself to yell at people. I mean, wouldn't their life hard enough without me throwing my authority around? No, it's not the noise level either, I promise. I'm just... Hell, I don't know. Worried about him. Worried about us. Worried about what happens after we graduate. Emmy's been kind of weird lately.
What do you mean?
Well, you know how we're dating now. Just don't know that we're actually, you know, cut. Or at least, I don't know that we're beyond friends. My friends normally don't do that sort of thing we do. Physically, we're a couple. Coupling, at least. It's like every time I try to find out more about her, or about what she wants to do with her life, she dodges a question. Well, the other day, I was talking to her at lunch about some schools I've been looking into. I asked her, have you looked into any schools lately? She shrugs in response, says no. And when I ask why not, she says that she doesn't think that far ahead. I ask why she had that policy, and she suddenly realised what I'm about to start describing and why we decided to clamour.
She what?
She changed the subject. Wouldn't talk about it. Maybe it's an uncomfortable subject for her. Well, she just doesn't think it needs exploring it. Yeah, but it's not just that. Every time I try to find out what's bothering her, she changes the subject to. It's like she likes being with me, but not getting close to me. No one said out loud, I feel worse. You could digest that, this bit of information.
You know, it seems to me you're more serious about this than she is.
I can almost feel my stomach twist into a knot. She's right. That's exactly what it seems like. Is that really what's going on? I mean...
Sorry, just talking nonsense. You shouldn't take my advice, you better know me. I'm just the librarian. I'm single, so you can imagine I can't know what I'm talking about.
Me too. That's why I don't give advice. That's okay. No, I think you have a point. As much as it hurts to even consider it. Yuko seems to try desperately to find a way to soften the blow somewhat.
Look, I'm probably wrong, but if you want to be sure of how obviously wrong I am, maybe you should just talk to her. Get some time alone and just talk about it. And don't let her change the subject either.
Yeah, maybe I should do that. Or maybe I should just enjoy what I have.
We have fun hanging out after all.
The rooms are nice, and the other activities are nice, talking to her is nice.
Don't really need to get closer with her.
What I've got right now is pretty good.
But that's silly.
I want to get closer to her. I want to be able to help her out with whatever is bothering her. But maybe I should wait until after exams are over. Maybe she'll brighten up once the stress is passed. If she does, then I don't need to worry about it anymore. If she doesn't, well, I'm perfect breed when it comes to it. I thank Yuko for her advice and head back to my room. Maybe I'll be able to concentrate more on my studies there. I'll leave the room after finishing my final exam and breathe a sigh of relief. As I said, the exams weren't too bad. Managed to breathe through just about everything but the English fine. And even that was acceptable. Wonder how Emmy did. Even more so as you're doing. She looked terrible at lunch today. And she was pretty happy to be out with it. Her wheelchair. But she was just so exhausted. Something from wearing her down. I was starting to really doubt. It was just the exams. I confront her about this one. I'm using the interpreter, interrupted by Katawa Shoujo.
Hey, Hisao.
Got a minute? You know what? Save here. Let's go. Yeah, I suppose I can spare a few minutes. Yeah, I've got some time. Nowhere important to be, or anything like that. For the reason my brother did question in my statement, then beckoned me back into the classroom. I wanted to get some feedback from you, if I could. I know that this course wasn't quite up to your level. Don't worry about it, science clock activities are more than made up for it. Well, you did. In fact, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. Do you think that was a worthwhile activity, just from your own reference? Oh yeah, it was a great way to go further than we did in class, and it was definitely worthwhile. Yuko seemed delighted by my response. That's great. Exactly the sort of thing I was hoping for. You know, Hisao. Glad you came here. It's always good to have a student who really gets into the subject you teach. In a way, it makes dealing with the rest of the students more tolerable. You're very good to this stuff, like a duck water or some other such similarly. Thanks. You're a great help, especially with that college stuff. One more thing, Peter. A bit of advice from one scientist to another. Also, to the scientist that observe around him. Exactly. Good. A simple question, the one that most people can't seem to answer. That's the essence of a scientist, he said. You observe what's there and try to figure it out. What if there's something you can't figure out? What's a scientist to do if he can't observe something? How, for example, can we talk about quarks when nobody observes directly seeing them, or black holes when observing them directly is impossible? About that last sentence. I think it was a couple of years ago when I actually managed to get one in camera again, NASA or something like that, so that was pretty cool. Well, scientific equipment's pretty advanced. Yeah, physics was always my favourite science. I think I didn't do much after school with it, but it's pretty my favourite of biochem and physics. Mutou irritably waves away my response. No, that's not it at all. There are tools. I'm trying to give you a philosophy. Think, if you can't observe something directly, then how can you observe it? Guess. How would you guess the movement of a quark? What is your guess based on? Of course. I should have thought of it earlier. The thing it affects. When I clapped it down together excitedly and whoops. Yes. Exactly. Good. Remember that, Lisa. Can't examine something directly, it's because you're looking at it wrong. You have to look at it from a different way if you want to uncover the truth. And if it'll lead you, then look at what it leaves behind. That is the essence of a scientist. You never stop looking for the answer. You never take anything for granted. Observe, experiment, observe some more. There's a lot of stuff out there that makes no sense, Lisa. Your job is to get it to make sense. If nothing else, I hope you've learned that here. I think I can remember that. Lula smiles, satisfied. Good. Now go enjoy your time off. You've earned it. And I fill the room. Well, I'll do it after this. I leave the room feeling a little confused. What pulled that on? Although, am I going about this with any wrong way? Do you mind telling me then? Can I go about it some other way? Now this is well bit. And thank you for watching episode 46. Have a good day and goodbye.